Welcome to the third in a series of videos on how to use OneFile. My name is Michael Walby, and I'm a skills and development coach here at First Intuition. In this third video, we'll look at creating and submitting a development task. Now, submitting development tasks is one of the most frequent activities that you will do on OneFile. Development tasks are used for submitting reflective statements, for recording exam results, recording attendance on skills days, recording evidence of additional tasks that are set by your coach. Now, there are a number of different ways that you can reach the screen where you can create and submit a development task, and I'll just briefly show you how to do that. So if we look at the list on the left-hand side, you'll see a heading titled Development Tasks. And if you click on that, it will take you through to the development task screen. Just going to go back to home for a second and show you that there's another place that you can find the development task tab, and that's within your portfolio. Now, your portfolio screen is an area that you may use pretty frequently during your time on the program, as it provides a summary of your progress against the various requirements of the standard, as you can see here. But if you scroll down, there's a tab here called Development Tasks. And again, if you click on that, it'll take you through to the development task screen. So let's look at how to create a development task. As you can see, there's a button that says Create Development Task, so let's click on it. And this will generate a new development task. Now, with every development task that you submit, you have to decide upon the primary method. Now, what does that mean? Well, it's basically the type of development task that you're completing. And if you click on the drop-down menu, you'll see a variety of headings. There's case study, exam, expert witness testimony, project, reflective account, witness testimony, and work product. Now, the selection of the primary method really helps your coach to understand the nature of the development task that you're submitting. So, for example, if you were to select exam, it'd be easy for the skills and development coach to pick up that that development task relates to an exam result. Similarly, if you're doing a reflective statement, if you highlight reflective account as your primary method, then it'll be easy for your skills and development coach to see that what you've submitted is a reflective statement. Now, in reality, you'll probably use the reflective account, the work product, the case study, and the project, and the exam. You probably won't use the expert witness testimony or the witness testimony drop-downs. But just to give you an indication, I would use the exam heading to submit an exam result. I'd use reflective account to submit a reflective statement. I'd submit a task that's been given to you by your coach as either a work product or project, depending on the length of the task. And I would use case study if you were submitting some additional off-the-job learning that relates to your work experience. So for this example, let's assume that you're completing a reflective statement. So we'd select reflective account. And that then generates a screen that requires us to enter in a date and a title. So in this instance, we're going to leave the title, the date as today's date, as we're submitting reflective statement, and we'll call the title reflective statement for second week of the program. Now, your choice of title can really help both you and your skills coach when you're trying to review any of your development tasks from the list in the main screen. The clearer the title, the easier it'll be for you to distinguish between individual development tasks and find the right one. Now, you'll see below that there's a box that has the option to tick holistically against multiple criteria or separately against individual criteria. Please make sure that the box holistically against multiple criteria is selected. It should be pre-selected as a matter of course, but just make sure that it is pre-selected before you click on start. Clicking on start will then generate your development task. So let's have a look at the different elements of the development task. The first section is criteria, and this is where you link your development task to the requirements of your standard. So if we click on the set criteria box, it will launch into a set of criteria screen. And you can see that if you scroll down, all the requirements of your standard are set out, split between knowledge, skills, behaviors. And then it has the modules for the exams that you're sitting for your professional qualification, along with any other units that relate to your program, including functional skills where relevant, and also skills days, which of course are part of your program. So we're going to focus on the knowledge, skills and behaviours because we're completing a reflective statement. And as you'll recall, a reflective statement is submitted when you're reflecting on activities that you've engaged in the workplace that provide evidence of your development in your knowledge, skills and behaviours. So when you're submitting your reflective statement, we want to connect the evidence that you're providing to the specific requirements in the standard, so we can show through OneFile that you're progressing towards completing the requirements of the program. So let's say for this example that in your second week in the program, you had the opportunity for the first time to write an email to a client. So if we click on communication, which is one of the skills in this standard, and scroll down, we can see that one of the requirements of the standard is to be able to produce written business communications. So writing out an email to a client for the first time is an example of learning to produce a written business communication. Now you'll notice that for each element or requirement of the standard, we have three different levels of competency. We have learning, we have developing, and we have performing. Now, as a rule of thumb, I would expect that in your first year of the program, you would largely be involved in learning the various skills, knowledge, and behaviors of your standard. So it seems appropriate to be clicking and selecting the learning competency within this particular requirement. As another rule of thumb, in your second year on the program, the chances are you've moved on from learning a skill to developing it on a day-to-day basis. And therefore, if you were submitting evidence relating to this requirement, you would select developing instead. And finally, on the third year of your program, as you're approaching the gateway to your endpoint assessment, we'd be expecting you to be performing that skill to a relatively high standard, certainly high enough to be signed off on your apprenticeship requirements. And we'd select, therefore, performing when connecting this particular requirement to some evidence that we're submitting in the third year of the program. But as you've just started out, I would expect that for the majority of you, you'll be selecting learning to connect particular requirements to any evidence that you'll be submitting in the first year of the program. Now, it's a bit subjective as to whether or not to submit a requirement that is learning, developing or performing. And I would recommend that if you need any advice on this, that your skills and development coach will be able to help you with it. That's particularly the case if you're not involved in a 3-year program and that your program is shorter than 3 years. But for this example, we are going to assume that we are learning to produce written business communications. Okay. Now, you can attach more than one requirement to a particular reflective statement. So if we scroll down, we could look at one of the behaviors. And let's say that we're going to look at the adding value behavior, and we open that up. And we want to connect this particular reflective learning statement to the learning the ability to show commitment, independence, and multitasking. Let's say, for example, that at the same time as completing this first email, you're also being given a set of accounts to cast. So you've got a couple of jobs on at the same time, and you're managing those yourself, you're doing them independently by yourself, and you're also doing them to the deadline that's set, which is showing commitment to the work that you're doing. So it would be entirely reasonable to click learning to be able to show commitment, independence, and multitasking abilities to this particular reflective statement. Okay, when you've completed your review of the different knowledge, skills, and behaviors of your standard, and you feel that you've identified all the ones that are relevant to this particular reflective statement, then you must click on Save to make sure that you've captured those requirements that you've selected. Okay, once the requirements have been saved, then you click on Back. And this will take you back to the development task. And as you can see now within the criteria section, the requirements that I've highlighted and selected are now reflected in the development task. So once you've selected the criteria, you can then move on to the next section, which is the evidence. And as this is a reflective statement, this is where you would type your reflective statement. Now, have a choice here. You can either type it directly into the box that's presented on OneFile, or if you'd prefer, you can type it into a Word document and then attach it in this section here, which says Add Attachment under Evidence. Now, please make sure that you attach your evidence and also you write your reflective statement in this section and not in the section that's headed up Feedback and Comments. We'll come on to what this section is used for in a moment. So just for illustrative purposes, I'm just going to type in to this section, I completed my first week, sorry, second week. On the program. Now, when you're completing your reflective statement, I'm sure you'll be putting considerably more information than this, but I'm just going to show you, for the purposes of speed, how to move on to the next step. In this evidence section, you can add additional attachments which provide supporting evidence to whatever you're submitting for your development task. So let's say, for example, that this is a reflective statement and you're reflecting upon your first presentation to a department meeting. You could, in this section, attach the PowerPoint slides that you used during the presentation. And that just provides further evidence to support what you're including in this section. The more evidence you provide, the more confidence that your skills and development coach will have in your competency relating to the specific requirements that you have highlighted. Okay, so in this next section, feedback and comments, this is typically where your skills and development coach would type their comments in relation to your development task once you've submitted it for review. They may provide you with feedback and ask you to make some changes to your development task before you submit it again for final sign-off. So do make sure that you keep an eye out for any tasks that come back to you having completed your initial development task because the skills and development coach might require you to do some further work. And then finally, we have this section here, which is the timesheet section. And it's important to note here what you are completing in terms of time in your development task. The time that you should be submitting in your development task should relate explicitly and exclusively to the time that you're using to complete the submission of this development task. So in this example, if you have spent an hour or 2 hours during your second week on the program, writing an email to your client, as well as reviewing a set of accounts, you would record that time in your timesheet. And we'll look at that in a separate video. The amount of time you're recording here is the amount of time it's taking you to complete the reflective statement that you're submitting. So let's say hypothetically that it's taken me 30 minutes to type out a reflective statement that summarizes what I've done in my second week, how it relates to the standard, and how I will apply the things that I've learned in my role going forward. We would then submit 30 minutes in this reflective statement. We then see that there's a section at the very bottom where you need to sign off on your development task. So make sure you click the box that is titled your name. And then when you're ready to submit it to your skills and development coach, you would click on save and quit. And provided that that box is ticked, your development task will then be sent to your skills and development coach for review. If you're not yet ready to send it to your skills coach and you want to spend a bit more time working on it, but you have another task that you have to do right now, then make sure that you haven't selected the sign off and just click save and refresh. And that will then make sure that any changes that you've made to this development task will be saved until you have time to come back to it and finish it off. But we'll assume now that we're ready to submit this to our coach, so we'll tick the signed on completion box. And then we'll click save and quit. And as you'll see in the main screen, where you're provided with a list of all the development tasks that you've completed, that we now see this development task appear in that list. And you can see the action required by the skills and development coach is now the status of that development task. So that completes the process of creating and submitting a development task. Now, in the majority of cases, it's likely that your skills and development coach would have created a development task for you and will send it to you, requesting you to complete it. So you may not need to create the development task itself. But you will, in this task section here on the left-hand side, see that a new task has arrived in your inbox. You can see here that there's a task to complete watching the OneFile videos on accessing and completing reflective statement. So you would then click on that, and that will take you through to the relevant development task, where you can then pick up the process and carry on from there. If you're now happy with how to create and submit a development task, you can move on to the next video, where we'll look at how to create and submit a timesheet. But if you have any questions on completing development tasks, please contact your skills and development coach. Thank you for watching.